What is up, lads? The debate about whatever a video game really needs a narrative component has been going on forever. There are titles that base their entire essence of the story and the others that use a simple interlude between one fight to another. Unfortunately or fortunately, Redemption Reapers belongs to the second category. This tactical RPG has a synergic and interesting combat system, but it tells a very banal and boring story. Developed by Adglobe and published by Binary Haze Interactive, Redemption Reapers takes much of what has been done by Wildfire and Nimble XCOM and Tactic Ogre and remixes it, with a slight innovation in a dark fantasy sauce. The gothic aesthetics is a welcome sight of relief from the usual paladins in shining armor of the genre, but both visually and narratively the stereotypes of the JRPG genre drown the non-combat momentum's almost undoubtable. Where this game very well threw its own take on the classic turn-based tactical strategy mechanics, where the most important elements in the positioning of a given character, in this Redemption Reapers review, we will tell you the pros and the cons of this game, but only you can decide if a title almost completely detoyed it or interesting narrative is worthy of time. Redemption Reapers follows the story of the Ash Hawk Brigade, the group of the five mercenaries called to help unspecific nation fee at themselves from the fourth ugly and bad orcs, who for some reason are setting fire to all the villages and the cities they encounter. Brotherly, they have seen an enemy so devoid of identity and with such vegetative motivation that we lose the desire to interview to rescue civilians. As the hours go by, a few more elements of the plot emerge, but very slow and with a lot of unseen fillers. We haven't had any satisfaction from the point of the view character development either. The five playable heroes and the other characters we interacted with at one character level flat as bored as merely appropriate the stereotypes they embody in a short and all good there is. Before analyzing the gameplay of the Redemption Reapers, it is important to make clarification. It's not a simple game. If you like challenges, there is a lot of in the tactical RPGs, but if you're looking for a more relaxed experience or where you can simply decide the level of difficulty, then be a better way. Already in the first 4 hours of the game, we found ourselves repeating the same level even 5 or 6 times because the enemies are so many and they hit really hard. Every character and every opponent has the stats that determine whenever or they can dodge an incoming attack, but sometimes the AI will go after a particular member of your team. Placing a hero in the wrong spot is a tantamount of seeing him die and dwelling your hopes of victory. Frustration makes itself felt, but once you get the hang of it, satisfaction begins to arrive. Redemption Reapers is a tough game. We can start breaking down its combat system. Following a pattern already seen, the Redemption Reapers game flows consisting of scenic cinematic sequences preparing the characters for the setting them weapons, equipment and skills, facing the hordes of mortars and repeating. Structurally, each map is made up of grid of the squadrons. Offers has uneven levels and has an objective ranging from killing all enemies present to eliminating a particular boss, and can include escorting a non-player character or accompanying the heroes to a particular location. As it's important tactical titles, the distance the character can travel each turn is limited, and every single square can mean the difference between being hit or missed by enemy attack. Each of the Redemption Reapers' 5 heroes, PA, and action points available to attack, defend, and use special moves that protect themselves or teammates. Every attack almost corresponds to counterattack unless the opponent is defending himself or specific effects come into play through objectives or abilities. Furthermore, each character has a sip which to heal himself, which can be recharged in specific points of the map and cause a limiting of movements for one shift. The most fun elements of this game combat is a chain attacks. If enemy is within range of multiple characters, attacking one of them will trigger a quick time. Even through player which allies can land additional hits against an enemy. Placing your heroes correctly could lead to your attack any more times than action points allow. The beating heart of any tactical RPGs is playable characters, and Redemption Reapers only has 5, but they embody the different styles of fighting with wide weapons well. There is a Glenn, that swordsman, very strong in attack but not exactly excellent defense. Sari is quick and agile, and when her daggers and her attack at her disposal is guaranteed to dodge the enemy counterattack. Laugh is a spearman with little resistance and healed, but who can strike diagonally from the several squares away, positioning him in the best way to make him inflict as much damage as possible to protect his allies. Yuris is being big and heavy with a lot of health, better to make him a target for enemy's attacks which he'll fight if form back his axe. Finally, Karin is the archer who can also hit 4 or 5 cells away, still activating the chain attacks. Scattering around the map, you will find weapons and accessories which to enhance the 10 stats of each hero: attack, accuracy, dodge, defense, movement, strength, dexterity, speed, resistance, and faith. And by fighting, you will level by unlocking skill points to spend it in rated trees. As you play, the combat system based on the 5 heroes evolves in unexpected ways thanks to the new moves that are unlocked over the time. This is no cover in the map, so for faith or not having AP to defend yourself may risking losing character and finding yourself a clear disadvantage. The enemies are many, and if you don't get rid of them, you could find yourself losing your entire party within 2 turns. When your chain attack are multiplied thanks to the strategic positioning. However, the satisfaction is very high, and even tatas of the bosses will fall on the edge of your blades. Redemption Reapers is the game that didn't need a story, but found itself forced to tell one, make sense of excellent strategic combat system. Enemies or characters are really flat, but on the battlefield it doesn't matter. Between placement, chain attacks, arrows, and broadswords, facing the hordes of worms is a pleasant or difficult pastime. The interactive cutscenes are exactly pretty to look at, while often to focus characters and really rudimental factual animations, and the 5 heroes' combat phrases are that varied and get boring quickly, but the videos can be skipped and the audio in-game is adjustable. What matters is the precision and fluidity with which developers of Redemption Reapers have designed its tactical gameplay. This game will challenge you, which try hard.